This is a video about unleashing your creativity. That said, we're going to make a hand puppet with little or very little preconceived idea of how that hand puppet's going to look when we are finished. Okay, so no restraints here, no plan, except we're going to follow a few easy steps to channel some of that inner creativity into a hand puppet. Okay, we're going to get started here by making the papier-mâché paste. I use a wallpaper paste for paper. This is sort of, this is a powder mix that you add water to. You can find this at a do-it-yourself store, usually where paint and wallpaper supplies are sold. Sometimes different brands even list papier-mâché as being one of the uses of their product. The only thing to avoid is a product made only for papier-mâché or anything that's pre-mixed, because these things, they're not quite the same. That's just my preference. But if you have a paste that you already love, then of course use that. Start with about 2 spoons of this and add water. I can't tell you exactly how much water to add because every brand is a little bit different. But basically don't start with too much water and add it as you go along, ignoring the instructions on the box. Mix until you have a creamy, lovely paste, about the thickness of glue. And then add some glue, about 2 spoons. A regular all-around glue will work fine. The mix generally isn't perfect on day one. After it sits for some hours, it generally becomes thicker, but also more creamy and silky. But for the first layer of papier-mâché, this mix is okay to use right away. Now, of course, products do vary. There's another kind of wallpaper paste that's like a cellulose-based paste. This kind of paste is a little bit more rubbery. It also works, but it's not exactly the same. Different stores carry different products. It's just a question of trying things out. I mention this because if you somehow don't come up with the best paste right away, then it can be discouraging because then your papier-mâché doesn't work as easily. So just know that there's different things out there and they're worth trying. And they're generally pretty inexpensive. The next thing we're going to do is make 3 tubes. This is going to be a hand puppet. So 2 of the tubes are for the hands and 1 of the tubes is the neck on the head. You can fit these things to your fingers and use masking tape to hold them together. It's better if these tubes are slightly large because we will be gluing fabric inside of them when we're finished, when we put the final clothes or fabric onto the hand puppet. To make the head, we're going to use crumpled up paper as our underbase because it's easy and everybody has some old paper to crumble up. And you're going to tape this form onto the neck tube. Next, we're going to make the shape of the head. So we're going to use some tin foil here to find the shape. And what is important is that we're not going to decide anything ahead of time. So just take the sheet of tin foil and you put it underneath the crumpled up piece of paper, and you're going to wrap the tin foil around it. And where it comes together, where you're going to seam it together, this can become the face of your puppet. You'll probably start to see something, some nose working in there, or some eyebrows, or because you have no preconception of what you want, just work your shape until you see something, until you feel satisfied, or until you find something interesting. This is something like looking at the clouds and finding shapes. The hands are pretty much the same. There's just something to consider technically. Fingers can be really delicate, so you might find it better to make a slightly thicker finger if you are indeed going for fingers. It works to make a thin finger. You just need to use many more layers of papier-mâché in order for this to work, for them not to break. If you are having trouble seeing your form, try to hold some potential eyes up to your puppet. These can be wooden balls, beads, buttons, bottle caps, pretty much anything beginning with B. And try. You'll probably start to see something. Paper. So, for the first layer, I recommend a medium thick brown paper, like the thickness of lunch bags. We aren't going to use any water, so the paper should be thin enough that the mâché paste makes it soft. Tear off some pieces that will fit nicely into the palm of your hand, and get rid of the pieces with a hard edge. This is less important in this particular project, but in general, the hard edge is always hard to get rid of afterwards, so I just avoid it. The first layer should be as even as possible and completely cover the form. Put paste on one piece of paper and tear off the smaller pieces and placing them on the form. You can overlap, but not too much, just so that the coat is even. Don't go too thick, just make sure everything is covered. If your paste is too sticky, the layers will pull up as you're trying to put them down, and then you can add a tiny, tiny bit of water to your paste. But if your paste is too thin, then it falls off of the bottom form. It doesn't stick onto the tin foil. So you really have to have it just the right consistency. Generally, if you're having a tough time with paper macheing on your first layer, it has to do with the paste, with the consistency of the paste. This has to dry really well before you put on the next layer. And now, the hands. The next day, your paste may need a tiny bit of water so that it's the nice creamy glue consistency. The next layer can be done with newspaper or another color paper other than the original brown. This way you can be sure that you get an even second layer. And again, don't use any extra water. You may feel that the underlayer feels soft when you put on the second layer. That's okay. It just means that you shouldn't really thin out your paste anymore or use any extra water. Paper macheing can be very relaxing, and I hope you enjoy this part of the process. It is a time where you begin to see the character of your work and think about what you're going to do with it, or how you would make it differently next time. This is part of the artistic process, this thinking time, and it is so enjoyable. I also like to read the little snippets of newspaper that go onto my puppets. I think it's like part of their soul. The third layer can be the final layer if you are lucky. You will have to determine after you are finished if the form is solid enough. If you plan to use this puppet in a show or a place where the puppet might take a beating, then I suggest more layers. But for the case of using it as a semi-decoration or a present, then three layers is probably fine. It will still last forever. The only risk is that if your form isn't solid enough, when you paint it, it can become irreversibly soft. So don't be lazy about adding another layer if you need to. And now the hands. After three layers of mâché, even if you plan to add more layers, it's time to put the eyes in. Originally, I was going to use the dry kidney beans because they looked good with the form of my head, but I ended up going for something more bulbous to match the somewhat bulbous hands. I always like my eyes to have something to do with the rest of the body so that there's some kind of feeling that the whole thing was created together. You can use a spot of hot glue to hold the eyes in until you mâché them. Here I just am going to use regular glue because my hot glue gun is out of order. To mâché the eyes in, I suggest that you try paper towel. It's fantastic. It gives a great effect, and you can use a little paintbrush to shove it into the little crevices. You use it just like you use regular paper and just put lots of paste on it and work it in. You can make wrinkles or all kinds of extra effects with paper towel. It is a little bit soft after it dries, a little bit, but not much, and it doesn't compromise the form at all. To paint the form, you must start with a rather quickly done but thorough thin layer of paint. I don't mean thin in using water to thin the paint out. I mean just don't put too much paint on. The paint's going to want to pull back if you go over it even more than once due to the glue in the mâché paste. So you have to go kind of quickly and not use too much paint. Just get the form well covered. This is your primer. You can use any kind of water-based paint for this. I use a standard scenic paint because it doesn't have too much latex in it, and it's just plain matte white. After this stage, I'm going to choose maybe what the puppet will be wearing. I'm going to keep it simple and just use a square of fabric, because this isn't really a how to sew puppet clothes video. And it doesn't matter. This is just supposed to be a somewhat decorative or creative puppet. You don't need clothes. So let's try different fabrics. My first instinct is to go with the more colorful one here because it drapes nicely. The black one would work too, but I think for the moment I'm going to go with this one. Probably I'll change my mind. Time to paint. Okay, so I like to use thin washes at first and let the paint find all of the crevices and cracks and inconsistencies. This gives a lot of texture to the head, and it's lots of fun. You can use all different color washes and they start to make layers of different colors. It's a really fun time to experiment with painting. It's not, sometimes you're going to hit this stage like I'm hitting right now where it's not at all how I want it to look. And the only thing I can tell you from experience is just keep going. Because your other choice is to chuck it into the trash, and you can do that. But well, that would mean that you didn't try hard enough to finish it up. I'm going to change my mind many, many times, even after I'm done this video. But for the sake of the video, I'm going to just go with what I have here. I think I went too dark, so I have two choices. I can repaint it white and start again, or I can see how the head would look with the fabric and decide from there. Yeah, for the sake of the video, that's what I'm going to do. But knowing myself, I will repaint or obsess over this head. That's part of the process. I'm a little less confident about my original choice here. I like the fabric. I like the drape of the fabric. And I like the head okay. It's a little bit too dark, I think. And somehow the whole ensemble is just not dynamic enough.
Yes, yes, I can see the future very clearly. You're going to repaint me, aren't you? Yes. Repaint me 100 times!
Black is a good fallback color. It doesn't take any attention away from your artwork, and it probably shows it off the best. It just depends if you want the costume to be part of the character, or if you only want it to be a support for the character. I also quite like this glittery fabric. It has some purple and red highlights which match well with her painting and texture. And I like the fact that you can see my hand ever so slightly through it. I think I might stick with this one. The only question is if the puppet head is too dark. And I just haven't decided yet. And I might not decide. It's good for Halloween, but that really wasn't my intention. Well, I'll have to think about it.